In today's class, we will discuss about the classes and objects. So before entering into classes and objects, we will see about the structures that we have learned in C. In structures, cannot able to access or use the concept of function. But later on in structures, objects have been declared so that it can hold the individual copies of the member variables of structure. At the same time, it can access the data members of the structures directly. Any outside function is also able to access the data members of the structure through this particular object. Since there is no security mechanism that has been applied in C structure, that is, this is what the structure, this is the keyword, and this is the name of the structure, and you have two variables over here. This is D is called as an object. So any object outside the member function with the help of any member function with this help of object, directly they're going to able to access these variables, so that there is no security of these variables because their data are being leaked out. So in C++, the structure combines the functions with data members. So there, the C++ introduced a new concept, a new keyword called as class. A class in C++ is similar to structure in C language. So using the class structure, a programmer can merge one or more dissimilar data types, and a new custom data type can be created. A class is nothing but grouping of variables of different data types with functions. This is the definition of a class. A class is nothing but grouping of variables of different data types with function. So a class could have different data type like variables and you declare funny at the group anywhere thing that functions is accessible. So variables of a class, you call it as a member variable, and functions you call as a member functions or methods. These two are the important terms, that is variable na enna member variable na solving, functions na solving na member functions or methods in solving. These two are the important terminologies that you will come across in the C++. Variable na ordinary variable illa adukku per member variable, function na adukku per function kedaiyadhu member function. Yena variable seri function seri class oda or member a irukkradhala. And in C++, it is possible to restrict the access to data members directly by objects. Ebbi neenga previous first slide la C la irukkudiya structures directly access panikkira mari paathinglo, but in C++ it is restricted. So the mechanism of restricting access to data outside the class, that concept we call it as data hiding or encapsulation. Restrict panirukringa data velil irundhu yaru edukka mudiyadhu அப்படிங்கிறது பேர் தான் call it as data hiding or encapsulation. Only the member function can access the data. Member function மட்டும்தான் டேட்டாவை access பண்ண முடியும். If a class is used in place of struct, it restricts access to data members. எப்படின்னா இந்த ப்ரீவியஸ் ஸ்லைடில் பார்த்த மாதிரி ஸ்ட்ரக்ட்ங்கிற கீவேர்டுக்கு பதிலாக கிளாஸ்ன்னு யூஸ் பண்ணுறோம். அந்த கிளாஸுக்கு ஆப்ஜெக்ட் டின்னு டிக்ளேர் பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க. ஸோ இந்த வேரியபிள்ஸை டேரக்ட் in the object nala access panna mudiyadhu. So I cannot able to access directly. And that is how C++ oda classes and objects concept is introduced. So some limitations and structures na in another point C la neenga padicha structures la irukum appadina there is some disadvantage or you call it as some limitations. First point is functions are not allowed. அப்படின்னா வேரியபிள்ஸ் ஆஃப் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டேட்டா டைப்ஸ் தான் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்க்குள்ள டிஃபைன் பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க, பட் அந்த இடத்துல ஃபங்க்ஷன்ஸ் வந்து மெம்பரை அலோவ் பண்ணுறது கிடையாது. அண்ட் செகண்ட் கான்செப்ட் இஸ் நோ செக்யூரிட்டி, நோ டேட்டா ஹைடிங். ஏன் அப்படின்னா டேரக்டாக அந்த ஆப்ஜெக்ட் அந்த டேட்டா மெம்பர்ஸை ஆக்சஸ் பண்ணிக்க முடியும். தெர் இஸ் டேரக்ட் ஆக்சஸ் இஸ் அலவுட், தட் இஸ் அ டிஸ்அட்வான்டேஜ். அண்ட் இந்த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் டேட்டா டைப் வந்து பில்டின் டேட்டா டைப் அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி நீங்கள் யூஸ் பண்ண முடியாது. கண்டிப்பாக டிக்ளேர் ஆப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ் யூ நீட் த யூஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்ட்ரக்ட் கீவேர்ட். And the member variables are one thing you cannot able to initialize inside the structure. So in the mariana silly disadvantages la vandu C oda structures la you will see. The syntax of structure is like this. Structure is a keyword, open curly brace, inside you have to declare the variables and you have to close a curly brace and terminated by a semicolon. Here follows the structure name. So So the struct name is nothing but item. The variables are int, float, and data types have been declared. And as you see, there is no concept of functions that can be used in structure. And the object can be used like ordinary object, and also the member pointer object can also be used in structure. If you are using that, you have to use the dot operator and the arrow operator to access the member variables of struct. Dot operator is used in the sense of a simple object, and arrow operator used when using pointer. So this is the syntax: object name, operator, member variable name. Simple variable means you're using dot, and if it is a pointer, you're using this arrow mark. This is the example that has been so this is a simple program to declare the structure, access and initialize its member. This is what the structure is being declared over here. This is the declaration part. This is the name of the structure, and main, you have declared an objects, ordinary object A and pointer object B. So ordinary object you are accessing with a dot operator, direct access and initialization. So code number you have initialized is 123, price you have initialized to some value, and quantity you have some value. And in pointer object, it is B, so you are here using arrow operator. That was the difference. Here dot operator, here arrow operator. Direct access is possible with the help of these object. But in C++, direct access is being used in C++ like this way. What is the differences? Instead of struct, we have to use the same one. Instead of that, you have to use the keyword class. And in classes in C++, the class is nothing but it is used to pack the data and function together. Data and function. Ellathiyum ore pack of use pannradhukku peru dhaan call it as a class. It has a mechanism to prevent the direct access to its member. That is the central idea of the OOPS concept. The class declaration, you call it as a formation of a new abstract data type. Formation of a new abstract data type. So the class consists of member data variable that holds data and member functions that operate on the data member variable of the same class. This is syntax. Class is a keyword and name of the class. Private and public are the two keywords. In private section followed by the colon, you will see the declaration of variable and the prototype declaration of function. Similarly in public, so the declaration of class is being enclosed with this curly brace and it is being terminated with the semicolon. The member variables and the functions are divided into two sections. One is private and one is public. Both the section is terminated by colon. The object cannot directly access the member variables and functions that is declared in the private section, but it can access the data member variables declared in the public section. Public section la declare panirukkaradhukku direct access permission irukku, but in private section you don't have direct access permission. The private members of class can only be accessed by the public member functions of the class. This is example. Class is a keyword followed by the class declaration, name, item, name of the class, and two section, private and one public. In private you can see these are the data members and the member function, and in public you can see the member function show. And you have terminated the class with the curly brace and semicolon. It is also possible to access a private member variable directly like public member variables, provided that the class should have at least one public member variable. Both the private and public member variables are stored in consecutive memory locations. Private thaniya, public thaniya store aagudhu, consecutive aagudhu store aagum. A pointer to member variable provides address of member variable. By applying the increment and decrement operators, we can access the private and public member variables of the class. So, edhukku the first location address irukum pathina object class or object ku da first address vandu adoda address ku first member variable eduvo adoda address da vandu object ku contain aagum. That can also used to access the private or public data. So how we will declare the object appadina, The member variables and functions are combined in the class. The declaration of object is same as declaration of variables basic data type. So defining objects of class data type, that you call it as class instantiation. This is also the keyword definition, that is defining objects of the class data type. So when objects are created only during that moment, memory is allocated to them. This is the examples. How you will see the declaration of integer object, character object, and class type variable pointers. You can say this is a pointer. So what is an object? It is an abstract unit, has the following properties, that is it is intelligible, it points to a thing, either physical or logical, and it holds the data as well as operation method that handles the data. Data or operation method or function. And its scope is limited to the block in which it is defined. So accessing class members. And the object can access a public member variable and functions of a class by using the dot operator and arrow operator. This is the syntax. Object name, operator, and member name. A dot show and C implies dot show. Ordinary object are in the channel dot operator and pointer object are in the channel arrow operator. Like what you saw on structures. So the public keyword, the object directly access a member variables of structure, whereas the same is not possible within the class members. Structure level the direct access panna mari class la panna mudiyadhu, because you have to use a keyword public that is used to allow the objects to access the member variables of class directly like structure, so that public is returned inside the class. It is terminated by colon. The member variables and functions declared followed by the keyword public can be accessed directly by the object. This is what the example. See, this is the point that is given, and the red color is of keywords: class, arrow, curly brace, public, and termination. These are the variables, and this is the name of the class. This is an example that what you saw on the structure, the same thing, but here you have using the class keyword and an object here, object declaration, member initialization, and since these are the public member function, you're accessing with the help of this object, 1.4 number, 1.price, and 1.quantity. Next comes the private. It is used to implement the direct access to member variables and functions by the object. The class by default produces this effect. If you declare private, it is being prevented for the direct access. To access, you have to use public member function. See here, this is a private. So to access this private section, you need one of the member function from the public section. So if you access like this object after class ka item no one which other object of edit 1.4 number 1.price 1.quantity add panning the mari panning na, you will get an error like this: item code is not accessible, item price is not accessible, because idellame private la declare panirukom. Private la declare panna direct object which you cannot able to access. To access the private members of a class, a member functions of the same class can be used. That is the public member function which can access panna mudiyum. An object can access the private member functions, private members through the public member function. This is an important concept in C++. Next comes the protected keyword. The access mechanism of the protected keyword is the same as the private keyword. It is frequently used in inheritance of the classes. Mainly protected enga use pannuvom, inheritance la use pannuvom. Access limits pathinga, this is access limits. Edukalam allowed, edukalam allowed kadaiyadhu. Public na, it is allowed for both the class members and the class object, and a private na, still private and protected with a similar other. So this is what the basic introductions about the classes and objects.